Hello, in this video we are going to learn about a rec receiver, so which is one of the high quality receiver we use in the CDMA systems for wireless communication. And here we can able to understand what is about rec receiver, its performance, its importance, why we are using this receiver here. Even though we are having some methods like equalization and diversity methods, and also its operation, or we can say about its working function. So first we can see about what is exactly a rec receiver. So a rec receiver is normally a ZDMA based receiver which normally operate with a number of correlators kept together in the arrangement. So now we know that there are different multiple access schemes available, and among the three most widely considered, that is TDMA, FDMA and CDMA, we know that code division multiple access method, so it has more features based on the technology and based on the generation of the networks. So here what is the main thing is, based on our environment, the signal which we transmit from one place to another on its way through to the receiver, the based on the channel situation, the environmental conditions and the obstacles present in between, multipath components will be there. So there is a chance to occur multipath components, they arrive to the receiver side with delay. So we say now it's a time varying channel with the delayed versions of the same signal which we normally transmit. So at the receiving side, what is happening? We can able to combine these all components with the help of the necessary device that we will learn further. And here the rec receiver, it attempts to collect the time shifted versions of the original information signal which we have transmitted. And by providing a correlator structure like a finger, a rec finger, so in that phase we can able to collect out all the information, and finally we can able to get a good signal with high SNR. So this idea was proposed by Price and Green in the year of 1956, and we know that there are many obstacles on the way to the radio channel, and which cause some kind of nonlinear effects, whereby we can able to estimate the efficiency of the particular multiple access scheme, and whereby we can able to say that the signal components which we observe will be distorted in amplitude wise and delay and also phase. So slight phase changes, but much variation we can observe in the amplitude side and also delay. So if we get signals like in this form, we cannot able to attain the original information, we cannot able to collect the original information which we have already transmitted from one sender. So here the main simple concept is, if the signal components arrive more than the duration of one chip period, one to one comparable, and if we found that one chip duration, so chip period means here we can say in one unit time how many bits can be transmitted, the time taken to transmit how many bits in one unit time, so that we can say now the chip rate or chip period. So the rec receiver now can be used to resolve this kind of, by combining these all, correlating and combining, we can able to further estimate the correct version of the signal. So now what technology does the rec receiver uses? Rec receiver uses a multipath diversity principle. So since everywhere we can find a multipath channel and occurrence of slight deviations which results in distortion causing errors, and this when we analyze we can able to observe the ISI, intersymbol interference. So here we also know that the basic propagation mechanisms like reflection, diffraction, scattering, so how it occurs. So based on the way here with M finger rec receiver, we can able to collect these all multipath components with individual correlator, and we detect finally the strongest multipath component. So finally we will combine based on a threshold. So here what we do know, that is the output of each correlator will be weighted to provide the better estimate of the transmitted signal. So when we look on the individual signal component, there we can observe the signal to noise ratio, that power level will be less. But once we combine with these all M finger correlators in this format of REC receiver, we can easily able to demodulate. And also we know the demodulations will be set based on the threshold level, and based on the error percentage we know we need to set correct these filter values. So each correlator detects the time shifted version, and we can able to make this. So what is the main thing is the delay. What is the kind of delay we can observe between these all individual frequency components? There is one chip period. So based on that we will collect and we will combine. And here you can now ask why the name comes finger, since we are using the number of correlators which do the function of receiving. So we can say we are using several sub receivers, so which are given the name, that is fingers. So as you can see from this diagram, the incoming signal is taken out, that is the CDMA signal. And we also know the CDMA technology is more effective, which is free from interference. But also due to some situation in the environment, in the propagating channel, it seems like we need to detect the good version of the signal. For that we are using individual correlators, that time shifted versions of the signal we are collecting here. Through each correlators we are passing it inside, and each correlation receiver here it will adjust based on the delay. And finally we can able to estimate the good version of the signal among these multiple paths which we have now recovered. So the main part with the REC receiver is here it will combine these all signals, which is small duration. So duration of the chip period will be something like 800 nanoseconds. So further, just assume we are having M correlators in the receiver, and weighting network will be provided here in order to make the things in a linear combination, and to take a decision based on the threshold. And correlator 1 will be synchronized to the strongest multipath. Then another component, we call it as a M2, the second multipath component. So when comparing this M2 and this first M1, there will be a slight delay in nanoseconds upon a slight chip period duration, maybe around 700 or 800 nanoseconds. And the REC receiver now uses the several baseband correlators to individually process these all. And this correlator all finally combined. And finally what do you get? We get a good reliable performance. So how the detection is done? Here the decision is taken out with the decision statistics. The detection is carried out here with a statistical way upon observing through individual correlators. And finally the weights are updated and the final decision is taken out among the same correlators. And the weighted coefficients are actually denoted by alpha 1, alpha 2 to up to m number of respectively, based on the setup with our REC receiver. And the weighting coefficients are based on the power level to get on with the SNR. And finally two expressions we can find here. One is considering the power level, or we can say that if the SNR is small out for a correlator, it will be assigned a small weighting factor. So what is the main thing is, so based on the SNR level or the power level, we will provide the concerned weightage. So for that we have a simple expression, that is the overall signal we can able to express in the form of a maximal ratio combining technique. And Z dash is equal to summation small m equal to 1 to m alpha m into zm. And the weighting coefficients alpha m can be expressed in the form as a normalized expression when we deduct the final output from the correlator. So how this operate based on this expression? So alpha m is equal to zm square divided by summation small m equal to 1 to m, then zm square. So this is the expression about the coefficients, that is about the weighting coefficients now we have used here. So finally, what we can say, that is with this RIC receivers, we can able to estimate the strongest signal as the output by varying this weighting coefficients. So thus we get good performance in receiving the signal. So that's all in this lecture today.